folks, and thank you for joining us this evening on EVL TV for the conclusion of the Season 16 UGC Platinum Highlander. The season, it's coming down to this final best of three here between MTS and KND. But I'm Gex, alongside me I've got, of course, Grizz, as well as the man Dashner behind the camera here working the production for us this evening. How are we doing, Grizz?
I'm doing great. You know, I'm excited. I'm ready for the grand finals. It's been a season of hype leading up to a rematch between MTS and KND. So, you know, I'm pretty darn pumped for tonight.
Yeah, these guys have become quite the rivals over the past few seasons. Tonight, KND is going for their third Plat championship in a row. They won it for the first time 2 seasons ago, and they have just been storming with it ever since. They won, of course, last season as well, and they're going for their third one tonight. They could do it. All they need to do is just win one best of three, and our three maps, speaking of which, are Upward, which will be our first one. Then we go on to Gullywash, and then a third map, if we need it, will be Viaduct. So an interesting selection. We kind of get to go through all of the good game modes involved with Highlander, so get a good selection of maps here, and should be a good match, Grizz.
Yeah, you know, I don't think anyone's super surprised by the picks. I mean, KND beat MTS on Upward last season. It's one of their better maps. And MTS, as we saw last week, beat DK on Gullywash. So, I mean, not surprising there. And, of course, the tiebreaker of Viaduct, which, if it goes to that, would be a rematch of when these teams first met in playoffs and KND knocked MTS down to the lower bracket. So.
Yep, KND beat MTS 4-2, as you said, on Viaduct. First round of playoffs, and we'll kind of give you a bit of a recap here. I know Grizz touched on a couple of the games there, but, of course, KND beat MTS in that first round, and then they got knocked down. They went through, they beat Ginyu Hoops, MTS did, and then they went on. They had to play DK, like you said, in the last match, which was on Gullywash, beat them 3-2, and DK actually got knocked down to the lower bracket in these playoffs by KND on Gullywash as well. Actually, they had a really close game with them on Gullywash. It was a 5-4 game. Of course, KND still came out on top of it, but you know, that may be a reason for their pick as well. It seems like KND might be you know, just a tad vulnerable there. DK did put up a very good fight against them, so like you said, good selections for maps this evening, and should be a very interesting one. We'll see if KND can pull out that third Plat championship in a row, and I kind of touched on it before, they only need to win one, but if MTS wants to take this championship, they need to win two best of threes against KND. They need to win one tonight, and I believe the second one would be on Thursday. I'm not positive on that, but they would have to play a second one. So it's a long road ahead for MTS if they want to win this one.
Yeah, but I know that the community is itching for a little bit of change. KND going for their three-peat here, and MTS trying to get back to the championship, the first place medal they've wanted. So I think it's doable. I think it's doable for MTS. I think it really comes down to a few players really performing exceptionally well. I think that MTS needs to have Yosh show up tonight. They need to have Akuma have some pretty good plays, and perhaps most importantly, Harblue just absolutely has to outplay Justin. If he has one of those games where he's getting killed a lot, they are just not going to be able to beat KND.
And we've seen that to be a problem in the past at times for MTS, where Harblue just gets killed a lot throughout the game. We've seen that as a problem in the past, so it's haunted them before. Will it again? Only time will tell. But something else to note here, there is a bit of a change on the roster tonight for MTS, isn't there, Grizz?
There is indeed. MTS starting Pyro Katsi, who had a really great game last week, been very consistent throughout the season, is not available to play because she's going on vacation. So they have instead brought in MTS Faint, who was the starting spy for Boat Team. But without any further ado, do you want to go down the roster? We got 20 seconds left.
Yeah, we go ahead and go through it. Over on the side of MTS, you have Akuma on Spy, Yosh, of course, on Sniper, Harblue on Medic, Spamfest on Engineer, Nursey on Heavy, you got Giraffe on Demo, Faint, as Grizz said, on Pyro, Mooma on Soldier, and the big Enigma is on Scout.
And of course on KND, you got Just in Time on Medic, Course on Sniper, Satan on Pyro, Ender on Engineer, Demento aka Jacob on Spy, Kresnik on Heavy, Scissor on Scout, Etni on Soldier, and Jared on Demo.
So we are headed into it here. That's your rosters, and that's what we are going with for this evening. Of course, Upward is a notorious map for KND a bit. They've had a lot of success on this in the past. It's been in, I believe, both of their runs to a Plat Championship before, so it is quite a good map for them. Notorious for doing very well on it, but they are moving this card up nice and steady here. Not too much action, of course, off the start here. Mooma goes in for a little bit of bomb. Kresnik's very hurt. Enigma's able to clean up onto that one here, and MTS is actually forced on their Uber. They had to come forward with it. Did you catch what forced them, Grizz?
I think it was just some good combined spam there, but this is going to leave Justin with a huge advantage that they are going to take advantage of on this first point.
And they are going to get right into that sentry gun, be able to take it down nice and easy. KND has made some good progress on this first point already. Enigma trying to cause a little bit of a disturbance on this first point. Satan gets his head blown off by Yoshi sitting on top of the hill here, seeing maybe if he can get a little something, but Corsa just denies that one nice and easy. So KND already grabbing this first point here.
Yeah, but in the midst of that, we saw Mooma just come in, take down Just in Time.
And Harb. Oh, Demento got in for the stab on Harb. That's beautiful.
And just as we say that, the medic situation is equalized, actually going to swing back into the favor of KND as Justin is going to have a nice 20 to 30% advantage here.
Indeed he is. Harb's still got about 5 seconds on this spawn here. Nursey goes down as well. KND is moving quite quickly so far off the start of this one. And, you know, MTS is going to have to break up some of this momentum here, but it's going to be very tough when they have so much advantage in favor on the side of Just in Time. That is, they've got about 30 to 35% on them here. But Akuma comes in for the backstab on the Just in Time, takes him down, equalizes those Ubers actually. But Harb gets taken out as well, so both teams getting their medics picked. Regardless, KND still caps up on this second point.
And Corsa just going huge there on a 4-kill spree right now after taking down Giraffe and Yosh.
Ooh, man, that's already these guys making a play. We saw Akuma doing some crazy stuff for MTS on that Gully Wash match the other night. And so far, he's already made his presence felt, but it doesn't seem to be doing too much. KND has just been steamrolling with this cart for the most part. Now, this is one of the tougher points to push here, is this third point. You got to come up from the low ground. Mooma tried to get in for a bomb here, and Nursey's going to be peeking from on the balcony here, but actually Mooma's going to get shut down. Scissors out of it as well, so we seek. Just in Time is at 70% on the Uber. Harb's at about 60, so not too much advantage for them here. Just kind of building these up, hanging out for the time being.
Yeah, and KND has made their name on this map by having an incredible defense on third, and times have been getting faster as people have figured it out, but it's still very difficult to break that 6-7 minute mark. We'll see if either team is going to do it here. And Corsa takes down Giraffe. That could be a great catalyst for this play.
Yeah, they want to go with this. They managed to get that Uber here. Harb's going to pop it off. They have a much better Uber here. MTS does. They're going to stuff it right back into him. Just in Time goes down. KND loses a lot of their players on that push there. Maybe they thought they had a little more ad than they did. Tried to play off that Giraffe pick, but didn't work out for them. Really, in the end, they lost a lot of guys, and they're going to have to restart on this one here. Oh, poor Kresnik just getting roasted over on the side. But that will be KND having to regroup here and try again for this very tough third point.
Yeah, a nice reset by MTS. That's what they really needed. Those first 2 points were pretty fast, but it's nothing that a good hold on third can't remedy. And what they need to keep doing is making sure Corsa isn't getting too big of a picks, getting too hot. And they need to make sure they keep KND stuffed down in this low ground.
Now, what's one of the bigger keys for the attacking team to get through to this third point here?
It's definitely flooding that right side if they can get in. But unfortunately, if you don't sneak in, you can get a lot of damage done to you, which Mooma just showed there. And he's on it just in time! Huge rocket there by Mooma.
That is big, because now that's, well, Harb's going to pop off his Uber, but still, Mooma made a big play, got Just in Time, though. MTS down about 4 players or so. KND getting the respawns. Health isn't the best on them at the moment. They're still kind of sitting back just inside of the house here by that one spawn. Not really finding too much ground here so far, pushing the third point. it gets back in, but and they still are going to be at a disadvantage here with Uber. Once again, Harv's got about 20% on them or so. So it's just getting tougher and tougher for KND, but maybe we'll see him make it happen here. Course has been doing very, very well so far for KND tonight, though.
Yeah, and that's one of the things we talked about earlier. Yosh needs to really step up if they want a chance at winning this best of three. If Corsa right now is just on fire.
Yeah, I got the top of the points for KND at the moment, almost top in the server besides Harb, who's sitting at 19, but Corsa at 17 doing some tremendous stuff for KND. He's gotten a lot of good picks for them, but seem to be struggling still on this point here. It looks like they're going to have to pop off this Uber from very far down, and they're trying to send Satan forward, maybe deny some of this Uber, but Harb pops off as well, and it gives them just such a better Uber here. They gotta win this post-Uber fight. Enigma's been hit rather hard here. He's very low on the health. They finally pushed MTS back a little bit. They do cap this third point, and they are going to continue to move forward here. Ubers are gonna be even, but they continue the aggression as they're sitting right at the main entrance to try and get in here. But for the time being, we'll see it even.
Yeah, MTS favoring that upper hold. It's tried and true. Oh, and they're drafted! Destroyed by Demento in the upper area. A little bit of fiddling going on there as he nails the trick staff. And they are going to flood up. Will Nursey be able to hold him off?
Ooh, got a lot of good damage out. Nursey actually did get taken out right at the end by Jarrett there. So Nursey goes down. KND trying to move into this upper area here just a bit. And they do have Corsa up there. Who's going to find Harb with the body shot? You take him where you can get him. And that was a great pick right there to get Harb just in time. He's got full ad right now. Corsa did get taken out shortly after by Enigma, who's lurking around up top. But still, KND's going to be able to push this straight in here. Don't even have to use it quite yet, though. Jared's getting very low. Should pop this off, and they do. So KND does use the Uber here, but they're not seeming to find all that much. Giraffe is out of the fight. Spamfest is down too, and Akuma. But KND losing their players here. Just in time, forced to move back. And they didn't get too much on that push there, but they did get that cart forward nonetheless, though. They're very, pretty close to capping it off here.
Yeah, great collapse on him by Faint and Mooma there, just completely destroying KND as they tried to get on that cart. Didn't get the frags they needed to get the final push in, but we're still waiting for Corsa to make a play. He's in this upper, he's got a bead on. And still waiting. It looks like he might get a shot off, but no, he is going to be kept at bay for the time being.
Oh, Harb getting taken out by Corsa once again. He's got his number tonight. And that is another massive pick. Corsa gets taken out shortly after by Yosh, but still Justin Time's got some pretty heavy advantage here. But Justin Time actually needs to be careful as the chase may be on for him, and he's a bit hurt up at the moment. I think he is safe, but still, they have 70% advantage to work with on this next push, and they've already gotten that cart pretty far forward, so one more solid push with the Zuber could seal the deal for them. Corsa gets Enigma as well. KND getting ready for the push. They're just coming up on the Uber right now, getting ready to send Jared and Sizz forward, and that's exactly what they're going to do, trying to focus down that sentry a little bit, but can't seem to find it quite yet. They have managed to get a few frags. Nursey, Faint, Moomer all out of the fight here, but just in time gets taken out by Yosh on the post Uber, and MTS down quite a lot of players here. KND not flooding in though. Corsa gets taken out as well, but Satan is going to be moving that cart. I think they might be able to grab this here unless these respawns do something for MTS, but they're very close. Enigma actually saves it, gets Satan on the cart, and they just barely saved this one here. Though Sue's actually getting a couple of good frags with the scatter gun, couldn't quite finish off the cap, but Jarrett will go for it here as well. Mooma bombs in to try and save this cart from being capped, and I think MTS has held it off here. I don't know, somebody's got to bomb that point though, because Kresnik's on it. They get the damage. It is just an unrelenting push here from KND to try and get this cart, but I think MTS has held it off at least for now.
And this is just a dangerous strategy for KND, just bleeding players like this without coordinating a push. It's just wasting away time that they could be getting a good Uber coordination with their flank. Instead, they're just kind of sacrificing player after player and then giving Harblue a nice 30% advantage.
Indeed they are, and they're going to just mow down a couple of guys at the main entrance here. Kresnik gets taken out, Sizz is down as well. Harb's just about to be up on the Uber, but he's very hurt. He's actually forced to use it here. They're going to send Enigma forward here, getting a good meat shots into everybody. Gets Corsa, gets Just in Time as well. They just destroy KND with that aggressive Uber on the defensive side there, and they're going to have to go ahead and reset and try to finish off this final point.
Yeah, I don't know if you caught that, but Muma actually had a great kind of pincer move as he came in from lower and caught out Justin. I don't know if that was coordination or just good positioning, but really nicely done by MTS's flank to get the pick on the medic.
It was very good. Now Harb is going to have advantage once again, and KND is so close on this card here, but just can't seem to finish her off. Giraffe did go down thanks to Jarrett. Both teams down a few players, but they're really just working on getting this Uber at the moment. I don't know if we'll see another aggressive one out of Harb here. It looks like they want to do it. They're trying to send him forward, but I don't know if they're going to get the ground for it. Muma's trying to go in Nursey as well, but I don't think they're going to find much with that, and indeed they are not. Now KND has an opportunity as they are just about to come up on their Uber, unless somebody can make a massive play. Nursey gets taken out by Corsa as well, and that Uber is just about ready on the side of KND. They've got it, and they are ready to go to try and finish this one off. They haven't yet popped it off, but now they do, finally, as they get themselves into Mentos on the cart, getting as much time on it as possible. Still hasn't been taken out, finally does, but they are so close on this one. They have a lot of guys on it. This should be the final blow for KND here, and indeed it is. They finish it off 4 points in 11 minutes and 3 seconds.
Yeah, pretty disappointing time, in my opinion, from how they played those first 2 points. Just pretty marvelously textbook plays from KND. Getting the force on first, allowing them to have a nice Uber advantage. Rolling into second, Demento had a nice pick onto Harblue. And then that third point and last point, even more so, were just kind of flubbed push after flubbed push.
Yeah, they really, really struggled on that third point. I mean, it's notorious for being tough, but they certainly got held up there, and the fourth wasn't too easy for them either. So, you know, they're going to have a big defense here. KND, like you said, they started off so solid, and it just kind of fell apart going into that third point and after that. But, you know, definitely not out of it yet. It's not a horrible time just for how well they started. Certainly a bit disappointing, but, you know, it's go time now for MTS as they are now moving on to the attacking side. What's the key for them here, Grizz?
Well, they definitely need to take a few notes out of KND's book. They really, if possible, need to get that force onto Justin. He's played this map hundreds of times, so I'm sure that's going to be difficult, but I'm looking forward to seeing a nice bomb from Muma and Giraffe, maybe, with some work from Akuma, but Akuma is going to get caught out early.
Yep, Satan found that one pretty quick. Muma's working over on the side here. Gonna have a little bit of a battle with Etney maybe, but Giraffe has been taken out. I think he went in for a bit of a bomb there, not finding much with that. Muma goes for it as well, but that sentry is shutting these guys down left and right. So it's going to be, MTS moving forward, and Corsa getting the better of Yosh once again here. But typical play, not too much happening as of yet, just MTS trying to gain a little bit of ground here to move on forward and maybe get a force out of the KND combo here, but so far not finding much of anything. Muma's going to jump up on top here, but he should be getting shut down in just a second. He did manage to get Corsa. Both Ubers are going to get popped off here on each of these teams, and Nursey's going to find Sizz here, and MTS continuing their push forward here, actually moving Harb and Giraffe to the right side, now moving towards the cart, but Kresnik, Corsa, Sizz all out of it for them, and MTS is gaining some ground here. I think they've pushed. Yeah, they've pushed KND off of this point. Now they're going to be able to cap up on first. Oh, Harp! Oh my goodness, he just narrowly fell off the cliff. I don't know if that was from an air blast or somebody bombing him, but he got so low on the health. I know you were just about to talk there, Grizz, but I had to get that in there. Harp, good job surviving in that.
I know both medics under some duress there, but looks like KND is going to kind of settle back into this hold. Doesn't look like they're going to be able to get the forward hold over the top of the tunnel, which has gained some popularity over the season, but it does look like they're trying to as Kresnik is pushing up that left side.
Oh, we'll see. Both teams just about to come up onto that Uber, but Kresnik's out of it thanks to Akuma. Satan gets taken out by Yosh, and the Uber's going to get popped out by MTS here. KND hasn't had to use it yet, but now they will pop it off. They'll have a slightly better Uber, but they actually don't have anybody around to actually Uber. They've lost so many players, and they just have to back up. So MTS gaining some ground rather quickly here, having a similar showing that KND had when they were on the offense, gaining these 2 points pretty darn quick here.
And this is something that a lot of teams do that I do not agree with. Hardly getting very aggressive without the cart being moved up. They have so much room to go. Even if they win a fight, it's still possible for Candy to come back. And they are just collapsing in on the combo as Giraffe goes down to Pimento with a backstab.
And Harb had the right mindset there. He knew when he needed to get himself out. He at least got out of that one, didn't get completely crushed by Candy. They tried to go aggressive, wasn't working out for them. They moved themselves back, so not too much harm done, but potential disaster avoided for MTS here. So they're once again just about to have those Ubers up. Both teams are getting ready for it. Jared's actually very low on health. He's got to get back to his medic, but they continue to move this card on forward, and now both teams have it. Mooma goes in for the bomb there, but it didn't seem to find too much, it doesn't seem like. So we're just going to be waiting here for the picks to happen and get these teams in with the Ubers.
Now, that bomb actually might have been going for the sentry, which Akuma had just sapped. And if it was, that was some nice coordination. Sis gets taken out by a stray flare. Faint, not doing too badly on Pyro tonight as he's subbing in for Katsy. And Uber is popped by Justin, forced there by some pressure, giving Harblue that 100% advantage that they really need to take advantage of.
Yeah, they've got definitely an opportunity here. They want to take this over in from the house, and they're just going to send the boys forward on this one. And that's actually going to be Justin Time going down to Mooma, who got sent forward on that Uber and chased Justin Time all the way up top and was able to get it. So a very solid play here. MTS has got a lot of time to work on this final point. They've been doing quite well here so far, Grizz.
Yeah, this is looking really, really good for them. They're applying pressure at the right times. They're working as a unit. Giraffe, just as I say, a Giraffe gets taken down by Corsair, who's just been on fire. Great kill streak going here as he's just lurking in the backfield, waiting for somebody to peek their head around.
And to give Yosh a little bit of credit, has been doing quite well tonight. We said that was going to be one of the keys, or you said it would be one of the keys for MTS. And Yosh is definitely hanging in there, but Corsa, excellent job as well. So both snipers, I think, playing quite well for their teams this evening. But Harb does have just about 15% advantage here or so. I don't know if he knows that. I mean, it's very small, but they might decide to go with it here. They're just about to come up on the Uber, and I don't know if they're going to go with this one. They're just hanging out by the dispenser right now, getting their respawns up. But Justin Time is now coming up on his Uber as well. So we'll see them equal, at least for right now. But it looks like MTS wants to take this one straight on in here. Counterpop's going to come out of KND. Mooma actually got his blown off by Corsa. Spamfest out of it as well, thanks to Sizz. And he's going to get faint as well. So a 5-kill streak for Sizz here, doing some big stuff on Scout as well. But the push not amounting to too much for MTS right there, as they are going to have to back themselves up.
Yeah, some interesting choices being made. Sizz actually running the ball and Cleaver combo, as we've been seeing, just throwing out those bonks all he can. Enigma trying to get in, giving some pressure, taking down Jared. Kresnik is also going to go down. So a nice little soft push there from MTS to take advantage of Candy being a little off guard and off balance.
And MTS is very close on this cart right now. A lot of players down for KND, and they have just so many bodies on the cart. That is going to seal the deal there. MTS is going to take it. And a map that KND's notorious for being, you know, very, very solid on. MTS showed them how to play offense right there, getting a much better time. And it blew my expectations, honestly. I thought this would be a pretty secure one for KND. To be honest, just, you know, before the match even started, it's one of their better maps, and MTS came out and played very, very solid. It's a good way to start things off for them, certainly.
Yeah, and I think this is leading into a best-case scenario for MTS, in which they don't play Viaduct. I think that's the map they just want to stay away from. They've had very bad experiences on it in the past. Can't seem to really take KND on it. So, you know, I think they really want to wrap this up in two, go home early tonight, rest up, and play on Thursday.
Now, certainly would be best case scenario for them, indeed. Of course, Viaduct, at least historically, has been a pretty good map for KND as well. They did beat MTS on that 4-2 in the first round of playoffs. So, like you said, MTS would definitely like to steer clear of that one. But I don't know if you saw them there, Grizz. We do have some stats in the chat here that we can go ahead and take a look at. We'll see. We were talking about the snipers. I'm gonna look at this. Corsa 27-9 on the night, 466 DPM with that, doing just ridiculous stuff. Actually top fragged on the server, most frags. Sizz came in second there, but that wasn't quite enough to lift KND forward in this one though.
Yeah, I mean, if you had showed me these stats, I think I would have just the numbers, I think I probably would have said KND won, until you look at Mooma's 4 med picks. That is absolutely huge. I mean, just some great plays from him coming in at the right time and always dropping his signature, a swoosh in chat, to let the other team know just how badly they just got dunked on.
Yeah, well, you know, it's regardless, MTS, they played very, very well there. It's, like I said, surprised me quite a bit. And that sets them up 1-0 in this first best of three. Like we said, they need to come forward and win two best of threes to beat KND in these Plat Grand Finals. The second one, if we do need to do it, would be played on Thursday, but they have to get through this one tonight. So coming up next is Gullywash. That is our second map in this one, and that may be a vulnerable one for KND too, potentially. Of course, they had a very close game with DK in one of their playoff matches there, only winning it 5-4 pretty narrowly, and MTS beat DK as well. So I think it will be a very close one regardless. So it's a lot on the line. These guys going for it. Like we said, in case you are just joining us, guys, this is the Season 16 Plat Highlander Grand Finals, and KND is indeed going for their third championship in a row, three straight seasons. They're going for it, but MTS is putting up quite the fight tonight. I mean, with this first map under play here, you know, what are you thinking for Gully Grizz?
I mean, I don't know how many more matches MTS can win if Yosh doesn't at least go even with Corsa. I mean, if Corsa plays like that and, you know, maybe gets a little bit of help on Gullywash, I just don't think they're going to be able to get the momentum they need to cap that final point. And I think that they've relied on Akuma and Mooma making plays in the past, especially against DK. And if the combo of KND remains kind of as secure as it has been in past, I think they're going to have a really hard time relying on just those two players. They really need their sniper to add another dimension. So I do think it's going to come down to if Yosh shows up and if MTS can kind of keep Enigma in that sweet spot that he's been in, where he's just been dominating this map. I know he doesn't like upward very much, so it should be a relief that is over and done with and on to a sixes friendly map of Gullywash.
Yeah, and Enigma did very, very good on Gullywash as well the other night, putting up some big numbers for MTS, doing an excellent job, getting a lot of frags, DPM, you know, the whole works, really did a lot. So definitely we'll be looking to him as well. Like you said, Yosh stepping his game up a little bit, keep it going. But, you know, I think regardless, we're going to be in for a pretty tight one here, Grizz, if I had to say.
I would agree. I've got dictionary.com ready. I am ready for a game of Gullywash, ladies and gents.
You can't go on to Gullywash without spewing off a few definitions from Webster Dictionary. And for anybody that doesn't get the joke here, you had to be with us on Thursday night. You know, that whole thing. Go back and watch the pod if you didn't see it. We were spewing off some hot definitions. You know, you might get a little taste of that here this evening. Do you have anything prepared for us, Grizz, for later on?
I do have one to kind of start us off, just an intro to kind of get people in the mood. A gully is actually referred to a small valley or ravine, originally worn away by running water and serving as a drainage way after prolonged heavy rains. Synonyms are a ditch or gutter.
Well, look at
the
that.
The more you know. The more
the
you know,
more
boys.
You know.
It never stops.
The more you know. I've learned so much over the course of these last few casts together, Grizz. I'm very pleased with it. I hope you can scrounge up something else for us to learn later on. Maybe, we might have one of those sweet pauses that we had from the game the other night. You never know. So we might have to pull something else out of the bag at some point.
Don't even say the word pause. Don't even jinx it. We don't want any of that. We're hoping that the viewers don't have to endure it either. But if they do, don't fear. We're gonna do our best to keep you guys entertained. In the meantime, I don't think we ever got your prediction, Gex. Who do you think is gonna t I know we're done with the map. Kind of skews it a little bit. What do you think these last two maps are gonna say?
Man, I MTS is playing hot right now. They definitely are. They showed KND what's up on one of their better maps, which is upward. But I think, I mean, maybe tonight if MTS keeps really playing hot and they can finish this series off against KND at least this first best of three. I don't see MTS going two best of threes against KND and finishing it out. I think they have the potential to do it tonight, but to me it would have to come right here. MTS has got to finish it off on Gully Wash. If they allow it to get sent into Viaduct, I don't think it's going to be a good time for them.
I agree with you. I'm gonna go with the prediction that MTS does take it tonight. I'm hopeful. I've been pretty vocal about, wanting to see a little bit of a shakeup. I love the guys on Candy. I hang out with them frequently, and I'm sure I'll get a little bit of backlash for this, but I would love to see MTS take it tonight, j if nothing more than to just shake it up a bit and show that KND does play on Thursdays, which they have not done for two seasons.
Yeah, it would definitely be a bit refreshing to see something like that, of course, since they have kind of been dominating things for the past couple of seasons, at least winning two championships in a row. I would love to see them have to play on Thursday. It would make things a little bit more interesting, put them on the chopping block a little bit, potentially. So, we'll have to see if that's the case, but I truly do think that MTS needs to do it on Gully Wash. If they want to win, I mean, unless KND really just gets in a funk, but I don't see it being that bad for them. Maybe a bit of a hiccup on upward there, but I do think if MTS wants to send it, they got to win it here. But very doable for them, to say the least. I
Oh
think
yeah.
MTS has a good opportunity here.
And I think it's definitely very important to note a few things going into Viaduct so that we don't, seem like this is all misfounded. We realize that, I mean, you have to realize that this is a different MTS from the MTS that lost on Viaduct. They have a different demo in Giraffe. They have a different heavy in Nursey. They have Mooma on Soldier instead of Milo, and Mooma has just been playing out of his mind these playoffs. So I'm hopeful. I think that it's going to be a very different game of Viaduct. I think that Giraffe and Mooma are very different players, which how they like to play the map. So it could be difficult for KND to take a map in which they found success on earlier.
That's a good point. I didn't even think about some of the shakeups and stuff with the roster bringing on some different people. So that could even be the case. MTS certainly has a different team than they did when they first played KND. So that's a good point to something to note at least. So we'll have to see how things play out, but we still have a little bit of time here. These guys aren't quite ready to go yet. So while we have a minute, do make sure you guys check out the Battle Royale t-shirts that you can pick up. There is information about them in the description, but the t-shirts do directly support the Battle Royale Highlander tournament, which is coming up very soon, I believe. You can check out the details on that down in the description. Get the t-shirts. They help support the event, pay for servers, prizes, all that sorts of good stuff. And it's a good cause to support. Love seeing more tournaments and stuff come out, all the woodworks and all that good stuff. But we are headed into it here. We managed to kill the time, Grizz, and we're headed into it. This is map two of our first best of three of a potential two best of threes that we would have to play. MTS taking the first map on upward, which was KND's pick. So this is now going to be MTS's pick going into Gully Wash. We'll see what they decide to do right now. MTS pretty much all on the ground on their side of the mid right now. KND's up by their choke point. Mooma's gonna get taken out actually by a good reflect from Satan. And a couple of frags coming back and forth here. Both meds still up. KND's down about four players. It looks like they were actually able to cap up on the point, but MTS is just going to grab it right on back.
Yeah, some nice positioning by Sizz to get that cap, waste a little bit of time, give Justin enough time to get that Uber, but in the end, it is going to be a little bit futile, but Candy doing a nice job of just shaking it up, doing some damage here and there, and getting some nice frags towards the end of that fight.
And Harb had gotten his Uber, but he was forced by some good spam out of KND. Just in time has a full Uber to work in with right now. Akuma's lurking behind, though. They haven't used it yet, but Satan is being very protective of his medic, and he will find Akuma there and be able to take care of that nice and easy. So just in time trying to move it through the flank with Sizz, popping it off just in time to save his scout. They send Etni in as well to try and maybe cause a ruckus inside a lobby, but Yosh actually finds an excellent headshot onto Mooma there and was able to take care of that. So that will be, well, it's going to be them trying to move through the flank, but so far not quite getting it. But here comes Mooma and Satan with a big reflect onto Mooma, who tried to get in, but Satan just absolutely denied it with a beast of a reflect. So that will just get it MTS to push straight back in here. They have the advantage now. They have a full Uber. They're inside of the KND choke, and I think they want to keep moving with this. They haven't quite capped up on the mid. Demento was in, actually almost had a good opportunity onto Hard, but they do pop this Uber off, and they try to send Giraffe forward a bit. All they do is just force KND back into their lobby, but a bomb back in from Etni, getting some excellent rockets off onto Hard, but just couldn't quite seal the deal. So we are leapfrogging heavily on these Ubers here, Grizz.
Yeah, and Harblu needing to pull back because there's no sandwich for him from Mercy, who just ate it. So a little bit of a lack of health from MTS. Gonna pull out here and have to fight this mid against a Just-In-Time with a 100% Uber. But
so, there's Mooma's gonna get right in onto Just-In-Time, not allowing them to get any positioning. And they force that Uber all the way back on their side of the mid, so not finding too much ground with that. That leaves Harb, since he was able to get out, it leaves him with 85% Uber right now, and they'll get ready to go with it. So they're just about to come up on it in a couple of seconds. Akuma got taken out by Corsa, who, we'll see, maybe so far doesn't seem to be quite as hot as he was on Upward, but that may to be expected a bit, since Upward's might be a little bit more friendly to the snipers. But here comes the Uber push out of MTS. They just jump straight up into the KND choke, not finding anything with it though, other than some ground, and they will at least cap up on this midpoint.
Yeah, I don't know, that was a little bit of a questionable Uber. I mean, just nothing really accomplished with it. I guess they forced KND back, but I think they would have probably pulled out anyway, knowing that they're at a disadvantage.
So that will once again cause us to leapfrog on the Ubers, and now KND is just about to come up on theirs. They're sitting over towards this choke side. For the most part, the combo of MTS is over in Big Door, so this should be a bit interesting from them. They're starting to work their way through choke right now. Just in time, getting hit up quite a bit. He's going to have to pop that Uber off, and they try to just send it straight across the mid. Giraffe, very hurt inside of the elbow, is going to have Sizz coming after him. He's able to find the frag. Gets cleaned up by Nursey shortly after, but now Jarrett's in a bit of trouble as well here in the mid. They're trying to fight off Nursey as well as some others. The Uber gets popped off. This is dangerous for KND right here. They're just sending him forward. There goes Jarrett, and Just in time did manage to squeak out of that one. Just barely is going to get back to safety, but KND losing a lot of players.
Yeah, great counter push by MTS, really following up on the pressure from Mooma. I mean, I feel like I have to be on the Mooma cam. I don't know where he is coming from.
I know.
The place.
He's seriously all over the place, and he's, you know, like you said earlier, man, he has been hot in these playoffs and has continued, you know, whether it's getting frags or just making, you know, he's just made some, you know, good plays for them. Not necessarily in the frag department all the time, but has made some good plays. So right now we do see the Uber sitting at 90% for Just in Time. Harb's just about to be up on his as well, so they'll be even for the pushes here, and it's just going to be up to somebody making the play to grab a pick to open things up at this point.
Yeah, this is the first last push we've seen. These are two very high level teams, obviously in the grand finals. They know how to defend this, and again, this is 5 CP, such a difficult thing to do, to push into this last, especially when you have a sniper like Corsa, a combo as united as KND, and just a flank that is not going to give you any room to breathe. Akuma caught out as he was trying to make a play. He had a lot of success in the last match, but being shut down fairly hard in this one.
I think Akuma had something along the lines of like 3 drops in the last match. I think it was either 2 or 3, something like that. But Akuma was just lights out in the last match on Gully Wash when they had to play against DK. So right now MTS is, or excuse me, KD's poking around a little bit inside of the lobby. They had Jarrett going up there. I think they were just scoping things out. They had Satan with him as well. Demento goes down to Enigma, but well, when Nursey, I don't know, I guess Demento and Nursey had a little bit of fun.
Nursey was eating a sandwich and Demento was trying to get the angle on the back and the game was just not having it.
Man, that's gotta love it. Gotta love it. Thanks, Half-Life 2 Engine. Oh, that's good though. A little bit of mid-match fun. So we still got these teams with the Ubers. MTS moving a bit towards the riverside now. They might just try to reset or something. They popped off the Uber to send Mooma. Actually, Mooma's trying to get up onto the pipe to maybe make a sneaky play afterwards. But that Uber amounted to absolutely nothing for MTS. They got absolutely nothing out of that. So they are just going to have to really move back here. KD has some room to certainly move forward here, and they are doing just that. They're deciding to take it up top towards the riverside here, maybe. Jarrett took a lot of damage. Nursey's actually all the way back towards last a little bit down in river, but they're forced to use this Uber in the upper area here. It's kind of an awkward push from KD. Awkward positioning for both teams. Jarrett may get caught in here. Oh, and he is! He was standing right on top of the stick from Giraffe. He couldn't get himself out in time, and I don't know if, well, Justin Time did manage to get out there, but KD's down a bit, and Harb is going to have this Uber here very soon.
I would just like to point out that Nursey is making the plays of her life right now. Just nobody can kill her. She's sitting in river. They're sending everyone, and she finally goes down to Sizz. But wow, I mean, just kind of standing back there, was called out, ate a sandwich, got back to full health, and then got 4 more frags during that life, so.
And here comes the Uber pop out of Harb and Giraffe, trying to do something about this sentry gun, but it's tossing them around like ragdolls. Finally able to take care of it was Giraffe, and they're actually going to be down in secret with Enigma, who's trying to get onto the point, got some good meat shots off on a Kresnik, couldn't quite seal the deal. Giraffe goes down to Kresnik there as well, so they hold off the push of MTS. They had a lot of advantage, were able to get in, but just couldn't quite do it. There is a level 3 sitting out on second right now, though, that actually goes down thanks to Demento, who got the sap and then revolvered it down, so that is going to be KD. Ooh, Akuma's lurking around here. Just in time, actually, oh, so close to getting dropped. Popped it just in time.
And just in time, but also Harbus went down there to a snipe from Corsa, so both medics under pressure. Justin just barely managed to get off that Uber.
Yeah, Justin Time was—he's kind of messing around with the arrows. I think he saw Akuma sitting over there and tried to give him an arrow, but he like took a really good rocket at the same time and nearly dropped the Uber. Got the minigun out just in time to pop it off, though, save his life as well as his teammates. So they managed to push out all the way from their last point. They're getting back into mid right now, but the bomb's coming up for Mooma. Well, he's able to find one onto Corsa, and just in time got knocked down to just 15 health. Does get himself out of this one, though, barely, but MTS, a very solid retake into the mid, and they are just going to storm right back into the second point.
Yeah, I don't know whether to call Justin Time lucky or just, you know, having some impressive movement and positioning. He's managed to get out of some very difficult situations and find his way back, keeping his team in this with Uber advantage. If he had gone down there, that could have been the round.
It very well could have been, because right now they have even Ubers, and if he didn't keep himself alive, you would see Harb coming in just about 5 seconds to finish off this round, potentially. But since Justin did keep himself alive, we see the even ones, as I was saying. So both teams have it now, and this time MTS deciding to go towards the riverside. Once again, it looks like Enigma got taken out by Etni, and they're just lined up over here. Yosh maybe trying to start something off if possible, but he's not finding much of anything. Demento's lurking around down underneath where Nursey was, but I didn't find anything there. So that is just going to be the boys hanging out here for a little bit and waiting to make the pushes happen. Justin Time is by himself right now. Actually, they're getting some time from underneath the point. Both teams have to pop it off. KD lost 4 players so far here. They are staying strong on it, but they're having to flash this Uber around a good bit. They actually might catch out Harb right here, and they do. Ender finishes it off, but Jarrett got the good spam out, and that will be a crucial pick for them to get some ground to repush. But Akuma's going to be lurking around here on the point. I don't know if he's going to be going for the back cap when they come out, or might be trying to just set up to make the play onto Justin Time. But right now we're going to see Justin with some advantage.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really know where half of MTS is when these pushes are happening. I'm looking around and I'm just not seeing players. I'm seeing the combo and no one else. So it almost seems like they're going into these pushes when they're already down numbers, which is just ridiculous. Just in time, though, as I'm talking, gets taken down by some great rockets from Muma, and the point is getting capped from behind them.
Wow, they just got absolutely crushed out on second. I mean, like, I was sitting there just looking down for like a second while
it
you were talking,
very quickly.
And
yeah,
they like just got demolished in a matter of seconds. Muma came in, got a 2K, one of which was just in time. But that sets MTS up right now at a 1-0 lead on Gullywash here. They took the first map and they have come out with another round win here. So KND on the ropes just a little bit here, but we do have a lot of time left in this game to make something happen. KND's going to get on this point very quickly here, but some good spam coming out of Giraffe is going to force them off it. Muma comes in for a bomb as well. One good rocket off onto Just in Time, and Fate finishes it off. Giraffe gets taken out by Kresnik, actually picking up a 4K. Kresnik with the heavy weapons guy. Look at that. And both teams just about wiped on the mid here. They're still fighting for it, actually, because you have a back cap going on right now, and you have a guy that just stopped it. I think it was Etni inside of the mid that stopped it, but regardless, KND grabs the second point. I think MTS is going to be able to collect right back up on it, though.
Yeah, I mean, some really nice positioning from KND. Just, again, same strategy they took on that last mid to just quickly cap it and start pressuring the next point. But this time, MTS seems to have fallen for it and lost the mid fight because of it.
MTS gearing up for something towards the choke side. Maybe Corsa got the better of Yosh, and Muma was able to grab Ender. But right now, oh, here comes Muma once again for a big bomb, and it finds Just in Time yet again, and making the plays happen, getting the med picks. He just seems to be getting the best bombs this evening, even through the course of these playoffs. And he gives a little see you in chat. He will see you later, Justin, as now that leaves a lot of advantage for Harb, but they have Kresnik and Sizz both back on the second point right now, and that's allowed them to cap on it. Sizz lurking around up top's gonna go in for this force onto Harb. He's very close to getting the kill, but didn't force Harb. He just decided to milk it, and it's a good call from him. So they're gonna have to cap back up onto this second point now, MTS is.
Yeah, great work. Again, I just look away for a second and Muma appears on top of the medic. Just that is definitely just keeping MTS in this game. It's throwing away Ubers for KND and better yet, getting those huge medic picks that leads them to their own advantage. So again, Corsa trying to equalize, having some great play right now. As
MTS
just melts away.
Absolutely deleted from the map. Pretty much the whole team, I think, except for Akuma, who also just got killed by Justin Time. So KND now is going to have a very good opportunity to tie this game up, as they are going to have Uber in just a few seconds. And MTS just getting their respawns, but Harb's only sitting at about 15% Uber. So KND, this is their opportunity to tie things up, certainly. So we'll see what happens here. But Muma's lurking around up inside of the lobbies, but not finding much anything. Etni gets taken down, and that will be a big one there. But Muma gets in on Just in Time once again, drops him with the full Uber. The man is making plays left and right in this game. He's done it yet again, and that is a missed opportunity from KND there, but all thanks to Muma.
And it just doesn't, I don't understand. They need to know to watch for him. It's every time. His lives have been pretty predictable, in my opinion, with when he's bombing in, it's pretty constant. He's had some flubs, but for the most part, it just seems like KND's always caught off guard, and he's trying to get more pressure here. Sticky's coming in, destroying them in choke. KND trying to fight that second, but just not possible right now.
Whoo, boy, that is some crazy stuff right there. Muma making it happen, and now MTS is trying to move through this choke a little bit, but they do have to deal with a Jarrett right on the other side who's spamming the stickies back and forth. Him and Drap are just having a bit of a sticky battle in through choke here. And these guys are going to have to just kind of back off, save for another day. Giraffe actually got launched on top, and Faint finds Demento behind the point. So here we go. We have Justin with the full Uber, and they are getting ready to move with it in through the choke here. Sizz making his way through. They pop this one off, but so far being denied by Faint a good bit here. They need to find that pyro frag, and Sizz finally does, wrapping around to get Yosh, and Corse actually finds that one from over in the choke, but... still, Harp is going to have this Uber in just a second. These players on the KND side need to be careful, and I think Justin knows as well as most of the rest of the team, but Muma comes in for a bomb, able to get some good damage out, and oh no, Justin Time's going to get crushed inside of this choke here. I'm making this going to go and try and chase it down, but it's just not going to happen, I don't think. The from Enigma, see you later. We'll make Justin bleed it out, and that is KND getting demolished once again.
Yeah, great kind of collapse. Again, I feel like this isn't the KND that we're used to seeing. There's a lot of misplays. They're not capitalizing on Corsa like they normally do. Etni trying to get a back cap going, but is unable to, going to end up going down to Faint. But yeah, well, I'm a little surprised at how KND is kind of misstepping.
My goodness, Corsa just blew Harp's head off. And that is a great play. After Muma's been making so many, Corsa returns the favor right there by picking up on Harb.
Great shot there by Corsa, peeking out of that big door and just blowing him away. We'll see what MTS is going to do now. Looks like they're going to passively hold. Muma sitting up top, waiting for another play.
Now we'll see. We'll see what he does. He's certainly in the position, maybe, if KND gets ready to push out. And they do have the advantage here. So we should be seeing them push relatively shortly. They're at about 85% at the moment and getting ready to make some moves here. So Harb only sitting at 25% himself. Muma tries to get in with a wall of players in front of him to just maybe even force the Uber, but wasn't able to find anything with it. So they have it now. They're starting to move in through the choke. They have to pop it off. Enigma gets crunched inside of there by the meaty meat shots of Sizz, and they will just try and send it towards Big Door as Garrett shuts them out here. So they will at least get this midpoint, though Harb is going to have some advantage here.
Yeah, questionable pop by Justin Time, but it is going to get him. Two nice picks by Akuma coming in with those hot headshots, trying to equalize this playing field as KND is down three. Looking to try and push back in. Muma chasing for that pick, but is not going to get any.
So KND's got to back off here, concede this midpoint as Harb comes up on the Uber, and he calls it out loud, so they know it. Justin going for the fake call. I don't think that's going to work. They pop this Uber off from down low, but Satan doing a good job of denying the jumper. I think it was Muma who was trying to get up top to the combo of KND, but he gets denied. It will be Kereznik going down, though, so the rest of the KND squad just needs to get back to last right now as MTS grabs this second point. And Justin will be up on the Uber here in just a second, actually. So they have it now, but they got to wait for some of these respawns.
Yeah, and time is just kind of wasting away. I don't think they're really going to make an aggressive play. Just kind of waiting, seeing if any playmakers are going to do anything, keeping our eyes on Corsa, keeping our eyes on Muma. Kresnik up top, peeking, just doing some damage here and there. Enigma taking down Satan on the flank.
He's got to be careful here. They have Yosh over at Big Door. They're trying to move this Uber out. They popped it off, sent it forward through the chokes. Is trying to get in, maybe, but they did a good job of kiting that one off there. MTS did. They just got right back out of the choke. Now Harb has got the Uber, and Justin already trying to get himself out into the upper area. Might get caught out here potentially, though. The sticks flying up towards them, but they weren't able to find Justin time. The Uber did get popped off by MTS, though. As you can see, and they will just regain ground on this second point. Once again, we're flip-flopping back and forth here. He's constantly in this game. MTS still with this 1-0 lead, though, and they are going to grab second.
Yeah, it's interesting you say that. We really haven't seen a whole lot of Uber v Uber scenarios outside of last. Just a lot of kind of bunny hopping around, trying to get the next point, taking it back. You know, just some pretty standard play, I guess. It's not per se the normal for these teams. Usually we're seeing a little bit more full team fights, but I'm waiting for MTS to get their whole team involved. I still haven't seen all of MTS collapse on an objective at once.
Yeah, it has been odd, and And still working for them, though. I mean, they
yeah,
got
they're,
a 1-0
they're
nothing
up
1-0. Lead.
Zero. They got 9 minutes and 30 seconds left, keeping our eye on the clock. It is one half, so whoever is ahead at the end of this time is going to be the winner of this map, and if MTS takes it, that will be their win of this best of three.
Yeah, and I guess we kind of forgot to mention that beforehand. You probably figured after Upward was done in just one half, but we do play just one half in these best of threes. Course against better Yosh there, and oh no, KND pops this Uber in upper here, and MTS has got the better Uber for sure. Jarrett gets taken out, got disconnected on the Uber, and that will be a pretty big pick for them. Harm goes down, though. That's Sizz actually getting in behind them, excuse me. That was able to get Harb, so maybe a bit of room for KND once they get some of their spawners here, and they might be able to push themselves back out. They will have, right now they have 25. They'll end up having about 40 or so percent advantage to work with.
Yeah, just going to fall back onto the second point, look for something. We're probably going to see KND push out. They have that aggressive style. They need to get a point back. They can't just be complacent here. Or they will lose this best of three. So I'm watching for Corsa to peek aggressively, try and get a shot out onto something to catalyze that play. But right now, looks like KND content to just sit back a little bit.
Yeah, they're just about to be up on the Uber. I would hope they decide to push. I mean, they still have some time. They have 8 minutes to work with still, but it will become of the essence soon. You can only say we still have time for so long. They're going to have to get moving and make a play here soon, but Akuma gets Etni and Kresnik and making some plays here. They're going to get forced inside of this lobby right now thanks to Mooma, and they're going to have to just completely back off here. That's another fantastic play for Mooma, because now that sets Harb up with a full Uber advantage, and they want to try and work this down the riverside right now, and KND is still down a good bit of players. They're going to get their respawns right in the middle of this Uber fight, but they're already getting in here. Satan goes down. Jarrett's trying to get some sticky spam from up top. They are managing to find a couple, but Candy's health is just not good at all. They're ill, completely ill. Etni, the last one up. MTS taking the lead right here, 2-0.
And Enigma just doing so much work. And we talked about this earlier. He is delivering the meat train to them. It just all over their team. 6 great shots, doing tons of damage in that final push as we gear up for another mid-fight of MTS versus KND on Goliwash.
Enigma certainly is giving him a little bit of midnight meat train here. He's been rocking, man. He's a beast on especially 5 CP maps like this, thanks to his 6's experience. But we are back into this mid here. Yosh goes down right off the start of it, and Nursey, pretty hurt, is going to have to kind of back off here. It looks like MTS not really finding much ground in this mid here. They're stuck over towards Big Door right now. I don't know if they're really going to be able to contest this too heavily. I mean, Draft's still poking around, but they just got completely stuffed right back into the Big Door on that mid. It looks like KND wants to move in through the Big Door nonetheless, maybe trying to send Sizz and Jarrett through, getting some good sticks off. It'll actually be MTS that pops first, KND shortly after. But they just send a Faint on forward to try and deny this one here. They're stuffing them out of it. Faint picks up on it, a spy pick, but will go down right after to Ender. So KND still holding their ground here at this choke, but they continue to fight it. And they're still going with it. Nursey, who tried to come up from that lower shutter, got shut down, and MTS actually losing so many players here. Harb might be a victim on this as well. He's trying to get out. He lost his demo, and he just wants to get back to last year, meet up with his teammates, but still looking pretty good here, KND, on this push.
Yeah, Hardblue with a very close escape, actually getting all the way down to, I think, 11 health there. Satan trying to come in and do something, but is going to be promptly denied by Faint, who I have to give credit to is doing extremely well tonight for filling in on Katsy's behalf.
Certainly not been bad for them, doing a great job to fill that position. Katsy was really big on this map for MTS, especially on their last defense. Katsy was massive for MTS on their match against DK. Really did a good job of denying the Ubers, but Fain has been filling the role quite well. So both teams have the Uber. KND absolutely needs to get a round right now. They have 5 minutes left in this game. They're down 2 rounds. You need to come out on top of this Uber v Uber fight and cap up on the point here. I don't know if they're going to have enough time. If they get crushed and MTS pushes back out, they can just park that bus. So this is crucial for them right here, but they're just trying to slow it up as much as possible. MTS is, and they actually have Akuma going for a bit of a back cap back here on the second point. So they will use the Ubers off. Both teams will. KND trying to make something happen, but they lost Kresnik and a couple others, and they have Muma coming in for some plays as well. Maybe if Justin Time goes down here, he's got so much damage out onto him, but Muma just can't quite find it. He did get himself out of that one, but Akuma's lurking around right behind Justin Time and takes him out. The teamwork there. Muma shoved him out of the riverside, and Akuma was waiting on second for him to just stab him right in the back. And that may just seal the deal for MTS right there. We've got about 4 minutes left, and KND still needs to win two rounds, but that's good stuff from Akuma right there.
Yeah, great plays, and Enigma doing a great job of just keeping the pressure on, picking up frags left and right, taking out Kresnik at the back end of that fight. But I have to say, one of the unsung heroes of this game, and I'm noticing this more and more, especially as I just take a peek at the stats page, Giraffe doing tons of work, 22-6 after that last round, with almost 100 damage per minute more than Jared. So, you know, doing a good job with the hand he's been dealt here.
Certainly, and Jared's actually going to get taken out by Akuma with the big backstab there, who Akuma continuing to make some plays for them. It's another nice pick. Harb's got some advantage right now, though, about 60%, now back down to about 50, but I'm not sure if they're going to decide to move on this one or not. They don't seem like they want to, really. I think they're kind of content to just chill back on last year, because time is of the essence for KND now. Is, you know, they're now down to 2 minutes and 55 seconds to win two rounds. I don't know if it can be done, Grizz.
They're definitely minute, maybe a little, I think 54 seconds is kind of like the closest I've ever seen to like a perfect round. And they are getting very close to having to do that here to even tie it up. So MTS spam fest just with that sentry as the push is going to come in from KND.
They are trying to move in, but they are just losing players. KND is, they only have four guys up right now. MTS holding off that push. They did manage to get the time down. Actually, Harb gets taken out by Kresnik, who came up from underneath, but still, they just stuffed him out very easily afterwards. MTS had a lot of players survive that fight. Etni gets his head demolished by Akuma there. So I think that is going to seal the deal for MTS here. There is 2 minutes left. They've got second point. They're going to be able to defend second. I mean, Justin is only going to have like 10-15% advantage here. Not really much of anything. So unless a miracle happens, I don't even know. I don't think this is going to happen for them. I don't even think a miracle could save KND at this point. But regardless, still 2-0, and they're going to try for it.
Yeah, I mean, I love these last-minute desperation plays, but this is not how you do it. Spam Fest with the Frontier Justice. Muma taking down Justin Type for what seems like the 20th time. KND just falling apart here, trying desperately to get something, but not going to be able to as this last is protect. Spam Fest just chopping down everyone with that Frontier Justice right now.
Whew, man, I think that's the nail in the coffin right there. We have a minute and 5 seconds left on this game here. MTS has a 2-0 lead, and KND is in no position to take this. Harb's already calling the GG, as well as Moom. All of MTS players are calling the GGs, except for Nursey, who says BM. So, anyway, it's looking good for MTS here. They are going to set this one up, Grizz, for a second best of three on Thursday, which is pretty nuts, because they haven't had to do that in quite a while, KND, in a few seasons. So they've been put to the test here tonight. MTS has come out and played quite well.
Yeah, I mean, every player really stepping up. I didn't notice it either. Yosh having a much improved game on Gullywash. Akuma stepping his game up, getting a lot of picks. And of course, Enigma, we all expected it, came out and played huge tonight.
You know, they're certainly the underdogs in this matchup, but, you know, they are giving KND much more of a run for their money than I was ever expecting. You know, I thought it would be a close game. You know, just from how KND's played in the past, I figured it was just kind of in the bag for them. But, you know, MTS showing that is certainly not the case, and they will force them to go into a second best of three, which will be taking place on Thursday, guys. But, I mean, with that in mind, you know, who takes the cake overall in the next best of three, Grizz?
Of course, you know, that's a super difficult question, especially with how MTS played tonight. I mean, God, Muma, just such a playmaker, has to be the MVP at this point. I mean, huge medic picks, great work, just keeping the pressure on all night. His stats, you know, 29 and 27, 300 DPM, looks pretty average until you scroll down and see that he has 5 medic picks, 5 of them.
Can I get some foreheads in the chat, or maybe even some pog champs for the 5 medic picks of Muma and the plays that he made tonight? Come on, let's see him. That is some crazy stuff that he had going on there, Muma. I agree with you. You know, MVP had, you know, just so many good forces on Justin, the med picks, just everything. So, you know, hats off to him, certainly.
Yeah, other than that, Corsa, I mean, sniping Yosh 10 times, keeping him under control, that's really what KND needs him to do. Almost the bulk of his frags coming from that, and picks onto Spamfest, the poor guy getting killed 5 times from Corsa. Ender, of course, always a really big performer, has done exceptionally well on Engineer over the past few seasons. Sizz actually outfragging Enigma actually outfragging everyone in the server. But, I mean, that's to be expected. 5 demo picks, 6 heavy picks, 2 medic picks, just tearing apart the combo of KND.
Yeah, and his experience, the guy has been around since the dawn of TF2, I think, Enigma. So, you know, he put it to KND tonight, definitely. Top frag there, did very well for himself, of course, over on Upward as well. But all around, just a fantastic night. Some of the problems that MTS really used to have in the past, you know, from last season, maybe even earlier in this season, it didn't seem to be an issue for them. And I think we saw a different KND as well. They didn't seem to be playing as I'm used to seeing them play, as I've seen them play in the past. It was a bit odd from them, too.
Yeah, I agree. They did look a little bit on tilt, a little bit unfamiliar, which is odd because they're normally just so practiced, so polished when these matches come around. I expect them to make some pretty big changes and really focus up for Thursday. I think it's going to be even more difficult for MTS to take this next best of three.
Yeah, they will have a bit of time to work on this one and go back to the drawing board for that next best of three, as you said, on Thursday. They'll have some time to work on it, but still, man, it's going to be a tough one. I mean, the playing field's even now, it's anybody's game at this point. What was a long road for MTS is just as long of a one for KND now, so it is definitely anybody's game here. But before we kind of get our closing thoughts and comments for the evening, definitely make sure you guys once again go check out those Battle Royale t-shirts. You can find information about those down in the description of this channel. Go check those t-shirts out. Directly supports the Battle Royale Highlander tournament, which is coming up. You know, all the money that you use to pay for your t-shirt, that helps pay for servers, prizes, all that good stuff. So you can see those up on your screen there. Check it out. Buy one. Do yourself a favor. Do the players a favor. The community a favor. Get them done. You can even see the link in the chat there. Grab them up. So, Grizz, any other comments for us for the evening?
Of course, thanks to both teams for showing up and putting on a great match tonight. Congrats to MTS for taking what was a very big underdog game. They were down 27-63 on Saloon.tf, so congrats on whoever made money there. Of course, thank you to, you know, all my pals over at Viper Gaming. Always love to give you guys a shout-out, even when you're not watching, especially to Cam and Ty. I'll see you later tonight. And shout outs to my main man, Gex and Dashner. Always a great time to be here. And of course, thanks EVL for giving me the opportunity. It's always great to cast with you guys.
Of course it is. And I will definitely be seeing you Thursday, my friend. We'll be here. Definitely make sure you guys are too. Thursday, it is the final best of three to decide the season 16 Platinum Highlander Grand Finals. Who will be the champion? KND going for, of course, a third championship in a row. MTS trying to break that streak right there. But of course, as well, shout outs to Dashner for the awesome production this evening, as well to EVL TV for having myself and Grizz on the cast this evening. And I think that will just about do it for us. Once again, thanks, guys. Thank you all for watching. And from all of us over here at EVL, myself, Grizz, and Dashner, we will see you guys on Thursday night for the conclusion of Season 16. Y'all have a good night.